who are public servants?
First, it is difficult because every now and then, my parents would be going somewhere for a session and I would be left alone at home because I am the only child. Although they take turns because after my father's service ended at turn, my father could be made a bill this time for the coming election as well.
What kind of public servants are your parents?
They are both been barangay officials as council, barangay councilors of our barangay. And even my relatives from both my mother's side and my father's side are both serving as barangay officials, and others are barangay secretaries and treasurers. They are all public serving.
You grew up with them serving other people. Did it affect the way you grew up as a child? Did you long for time for them because they were always outside serving other people?
No, definitely. They always have time for me. Aside from work, in an agenda where both my parents are working for and at the same time serving, they still have much of the time for me. They had managed, let me become a cum laude graduate. And they helped my confidence, even though they did not finish college. But they made me graduate even as PhD. So that is how much I am grateful. And I will always remember this part of the PhD. My father was always caring me to avoid having rashes that is still present in my mind. It's in my brain, because that is how much my parents love me.
Did you even expect to be like them as a public servant growing up?
Yes, because when I happened to be in college that time, I was only serving as BOT or board of director in our water system. We have a private water system that runs on our behalf. I was serving as a board of director already at a very early age. So we've been getting, since I'm inclined into mathematics, so I'm getting the water consumption of each houses. Imagine that, although I'm not alone, we are five, then we take turns, collect the money. So that was where I started serving on barangay at a early age. And then when I have already a job in Science Cyber, yes, that is my first station, during us give back or pay back to my barangay, I was always been an MC in a barangay fiesta, minus a city contest, or my really MC. And then I always a part of the activities of the barangay, since my parents are in the activities. They will always be getting me then as one of the coordinator of that activity. Even getting up drive in barangay, I always started that. Although that time I cannot run as a desk kagawad because I will be finding a job in the government. You cannot serve to them because I am applying for a contractual position in the city because I am after passing for the city. So I am already in the service also to my barangay because until now I am having my tutorial class even before I am still a single path. When I started my profession as a teacher, I always had tutorial class because that is where I am. For me, I am good at it. So I always had tutorial class with them. And then later on, karon, this moment, I have five to eight students sometimes some are absent. And then I cater to them as part of my tutorial for my daughter. So they are a team.
So apiloy mo na.
Yes, apiloy ako.
Okay, sige ma'am. Napay sitwasyon, was there a situation in your life na was a turning point that propelled you to support the community? Napay na yung sitwasyon?
Yes. Especially when the time that I am already in science side, I was assigned to be an in-depth coordinator. So I am assigned to the drug, the national program for drugs, so implementation for the drugs. So I am already in the service for them by going to the policeman to discuss, asking about their expertise for my students in order for them to get away from drugs. And then when I become a teacher at Paisipi National High School, which I guess I'm serving until now for 10 years now. So, sir, because Sir Alas has had seen my passion not only to serve, into the work that I have put into. So, and whatever. But if whatever assignment he will be giving to me, he had seen the passion in me. So although he is a first hesitant to get me, since I am a girl, he is hesitant to get me as a DRRN coordinator, but since it is all not all about action, but it's all about contingency planning and everything. So then he discovered to get me. And there I decided to create a handbook. A handbook which will, I believe, could help not only my students, but even their families and the people that
I know. Since ma'am, ang turning point ni mo, kagtong pagkita ni Saras at ni mo.
Yes.
So since then, mo na siya murag.
Oh,
nilupad na ka.
Oh, nilupad. From there, when Sir Alas has discovered me, he had given me the free will to do all the things that I wanted to do with his 100% support. So then he had given me the chance to choose who will be the people under my team. So he had openly shared his resources even in complying or getting, because DRRN, the school disaster risk reduction of Paisipi National High School, to think about 4,000 students is not easy for a girl to manage a certain school. But I manage it is because I have big people with me as well.
Can you identify these important people who have been the backbone of your initiative?
Yes, that is Sir Michael Gilberti. He even initiated the Sunog sa Paisal, which he coordinated with me. That is why the two of us work together on that. We have Sir Donald C. Campoy, who is into his heart of helping the school. He is our safety officer, and with me through all the plannings. Without them, without Sir Michael, without Sir Don, when we have also Sir Roy Den, Kiki, and Juven, we are these are the people that started our team until we grow this many. We are already 30 in a team. So we are already 30 in a team, but then despite four people that is with me started everything. So I really love pictures, and I really have, because I believe that it becomes the story of my life. That is why, good or bad, I posted that, because I really love to see it, because I can see the changes of everything. So then I really can't believe that those little pictures that I kept will go this way.
Mom, you didn't expect this to happen.
Yes.
Never. Pero dihang nakita na sa tatang kay tao ang mga industry. What did it talk about? Kung say, ditudlo aning mga experience ni mo nga, you went into a bigger screen showing this initiative. Kung say, ditudlo aning niyo.
To remain humble despite this fact, despite the, although Lily at the very start, I am not really happy of receiving that. Yes, I'm not really happy of receiving that award, the DRRN award, which is, imagine there are five who qualified, and I am the only one who won during that competition. And there are so many questions during the interview. Mamaya, the rest of the team, sir, the team, the Paisipi team, really, really had seen, Sir Franco had seen the effort and that my team exerted on how I answered all the questions. But then I had done that not because of, because that's my, that is my passion. But then when I won, I am happy for the fact that I am the one. But I felt bad. I felt really bad because during the round of education program supervisor for SGMA, although I am hitting two birds at one stone because I am also applying for a master teacher degree, I got a zero score on the awards in which the fact I am the only one at Baguio City Division. Yes, I get zero in that score. I won two awards, two succeeding awards for outstanding PRM implementer. It is not an outstanding achievement in my ranking because I got zero. But despite that, I never questioned the capacity of our team because everything happens for a reason and God has a purpose for everything. I remain happy, I remain patient, I remain grateful.
Taas kay kag maabot at ilutang ng taas travel. We actually defined by the journey, as they say, but we're not defined by the accolades that we receive, but by the journey that we take. And the gems of those people really matters to us. With all said and done in your public life, as a public servant, let's go back to your family. You said that you're only daughter. Now you also have only daughter with you. How were you able to become a good mother and a wife to your husband? Despite all of these things that we do.
Let's face the fact that I am not a superhero. Let's face that fact. So, when I reach home, it will be fire sometimes. But I, because God had given me this high energy, so I really have my time to really be a good mother at first. I provided their medicines for their heart problems. And as well, being their nurse and being their confidant in everything. I tried my best because I love my family, my parents so much. Because they're with me through thick and thin. Well, being a wife, I am very happy. We are not perfect. And every couple has problems. And I know, and you know all of that. But we choose to stay together. We choose to create more memories every day and to forgive and to love each other more. And I am an only child, the same as me, an only child. But I believe that with my divided time, I still managed to turn teacher. That is why I conducted tutorial class. Because we all know that students or pupils really have difficulty in mathematics. The only thing that gives them difficulty is that subject. So I see to it that I help my daughter at the same time, help other students may not be in the same grade level, but I teach them the basic mathematics. So I raise an intelligent daughter. Every year, I'm so glad that she had raised with her grades. And she got 97 this year, so I am so happy that despite me, I am a public servant because I am a teacher. My husband is a public servant because he's a police officer. My mother is serving as a barangay counselor. All of us in my house where we live together are all missing. But I managed to have a baby who won in a battle of the brains, managed to send her to school where she won poster making contest and other contests in the school. Managed to become a Taekwondo participant, student of Taekwondo, which she's a very thin girl and managed to love that sport. So I could see myself in my baby that she really is into a lot of things. She can also manage time well, just like me. The only difference about is I am really an outgoing person, and my baby is not like me.
So now, Mom, if you're gonna thank a few important people that could help you or help you reach where you are now, who would those be?
Of course, first is my parents. In everything that I do, he's been a driver, a messenger, and my baby. He's been there, but supports me. And of course, the people in the Department of Education. Of course, the our spirit, Dr. Bernadette. We just met, but I know he felt out. She had helped me every way she could. And of course to serve Alas As for honing me then, for discovering me. And of course, Mama, we've been together for so many seminars. She really has confidence in me. She had choosing me every now and then, every sentence. Sir Franco, from Engineer Kalumpa, and to the entire my Dukosti as well. Of course, Sir Harvey's Miss Janina also helped me, and my 32nd year and team of bicycles. All the students and everyone who really had showed their help to me and to me.
If you're gonna encapsulate your lesson throughout this entire journey in one sentence, what would it be?
My entire journey is not easy, but it is, and humbling and rewarding.